Now let's work on finding the intersection of planes. Let's start by assuming we have two planes, ax plus by plus cz equals k1, and dx plus ey plus fz equals k2, where the normal vectors, a, b, c, and d, e, f, aren't parallel. Given two non-parallel planes, I claim their intersection will be a line instead of a single point. From the picture, this may seem intuitive, but how can we show this fact algebraically in all cases? Let's use a tool from the previous lesson, the cross product. Consider the cross product of these two normal vectors, n1 and n2. Since the two normal vectors are not parallel, their cross product will not be zero. Also remember that n1 cross n2 will be orthogonal to both n1 and n2. Let's pick an arbitrary point in the intersection of the two planes and call it x0. If x is any other point in the intersection, then let's call d sub x the vector from x0 to x. Since x0 and x are both in the first plane, the vector connecting them, d sub x, will be orthogonal to the normal vector to the first plane, n1. By similar reasoning, since x0 and x are both in plane 2, the vector connecting them, dx, will be orthogonal to n2. Since dx is orthogonal to both n1 and n2, and since we're in three dimensions, dx must be parallel to the cross product of n1 and n2. Since dx is parallel to n1 cross n2, no matter what x we picked, that means the intersection of these two planes has to be a line that is parallel to n1 cross n2. So what are the consequences of this? Well, if we have a system of two linear equations in three dimensions, then the set of points satisfying the system could form a line's worth of solutions if the equations define two planes that are not parallel, no solutions if the equations define different parallel planes, or a whole plane's worth of solutions if the two equations define the same plane. However, if we introduce a third equation to our system, then we could have another possibility. The common intersection of the three planes could be a single point, or it could be a line, a plane, or nothing at all. There are a few important observations we should make here. Recall that one equation in two variables defines a line, or a one-dimensional linear object. A single equation in three-dimensional space defines a plane, which is a two-dimensional linear object. In general, a single equation in some number of variables will define a linear object that has a number of dimensions one less than the number of variables. However, we need to be careful to distinguish between an equation, say, in two variables, and an equation in, say, three variables, where one of the variables has a coefficient of zero. In the former case, the equation defines a line in 2D, but in the latter case, the equation defines a plane in 3D. Being aware of the context of your problem will help you avoid this error. Another observation is that the coefficients of the variables in a linear equation give the coordinates for a normal vector to the linear object it defines. So for the line ax plus by equals k, we obtain the normal vector ab, and for the plane ax plus by plus cz equals k, we have a normal vector of abc. This trend will continue as we move into higher dimensions, and again, this is why the normal vector is a useful piece of information for defining a linear object. One last observation is that we need at least two lines in two variables to obtain a unique intersection of lines, and we need at least three planes in three-dimensional space, or three variables, to obtain a unique intersection of the planes. This observation will generalize as we progress into higher dimensions, and in a little bit, we'll see an algebraic reason why it holds.